Hey guys, Dirt here, and welcome to another episode of Formers Friday. And yes, we're actually doing this one live. We're live streaming on YouTube, and hopefully everything's going to work out fine with the audio. We've had some issues trying to do these live streams, but today we do have something that I think is actually pretty cool. And I know some of you are going to argue, Battle Beasts, like Battle Beasts in the U.S., they were never part of Transformers, but in Japan they were. They were known as the Beast Formers, and they were a key part, I believe it was the Headmasters era of figures. And so a few years ago, they did a revival called Beast Saga, where they brought it back, and not what you saw in the U.S. with those Minimates-type figures from Diamond Select Toys. That was something completely different. This was actually returning to what you remember as the actual Battle Beasts of your childhood. And so Battle Beasts, Beast Formers, Beast Saga, it's all really the same thing. But today we've got some mini playsets. I believe these are from 2011, 2012, somewhere in there. And we're going to hop over in the photo tent and take a look at those. And you can see I've got four of them here. And from what it just looks like, you know, to me, it looks like these three turn into vehicles and this one turns into some sort of headquarters. And I'm not sure exactly how it works. And there's, you can see some different things going on. Like, for instance, these two have these black ribbons down here. I don't speak any Japanese. These two have white, so they're probably like different factions or something. I can't read anything on any of these except where it says Beast Saga and Takara Tomy. That's about the only thing I can make out on here. So I know that it had the same, you know, air, wood, fire mechanics that we had here, although when they brought them back in Beast Saga, instead of having the emblems on their chest for you to play with, they had a dice rolling mechanism that went with it. So you would roll the dice to see how they would attack and fight each other instead of, you know, just doing the paper, rock, scissors style of having the symbols, you know, face off against each other. Now, this is number 28. This is 35, 48, and 49. And again, how exactly that breaks down, what importance that has, I don't know. But again, darker backgrounds and lighter backgrounds here. So that's got to have something to do with it. So I'm going to take these two out for now and just set them aside. And we're going to take a quick look at these. And you can see on the back, it shows some interesting stuff. You've got these little action pictures of them there. You've got a shot, you know, as the cube starts to break out, and then what they actually turn into. And you've got some little clues here about what moves around. And again, I can't read, you know, there's some numbers. Ooh, look, a one, a two, a three. I can follow that. Nothing else here, though, makes any sense to me whatsoever. So, looking at these packages, it's a full plastic front and bubble, and then the card back is actually taped. You can see, I don't know if the camera picks that up, but there's a little piece of tape right there that's holding it on. So these card backs are actually meant for you to slice them and slide them out. And of course, now that we've started filming, I go to grab my my handy knife, and it's not sitting here. So I'm going to do my best with my horrible fingernails here, see if I can slice through these. And that one, okay, that was pretty easy, I think. Oh wait, is there more at the top? Oh yeah, there was more up here. And now I can't get it to do anything. All right, well, nonetheless, what do we got inside here? Inside the cardboard, we've got some sort of plastic pouch. And in this pouch, it looks like our instructions and everything. More Japanese for me not to read. And you can see it's the box, three little guys, and whatever this info card is. They're all pictured there. And there it shows. Okay, so not only does it show you how it folds out, but we've got some different clues here about putting the guys inside, how some of the pieces open and close, and then it looks like how to fold it back up. Pushing some parts in, flipping it up, flipping it over, flipping it back. All right. Pretty easy, standard type stuff. And then let's pull out the plastic bubble here. And we can see our first little set of dudes. And these are tiny. I mean, I know I got big hands, but these things are even tinier than I would expect. Now, I don't know how well this camera is going to be able to focus in on these tiny things, especially with them being the red that they are. That red is just death for a lot of cameras. So I'm not sure if you can make out some of these details. Looks a little tough to get a focus on. But yeah, these basically look like Battle Beasts. If you remember the Battle Beasts from your childhood, this is what they look like, except obviously a lot smaller. And they do have the hole in their chest, the square here where the symbol would be. But let's look at the actual toy itself here. If we can get it out. And we see it's got some wheels here on the bottom so it can roll along. And I'm guessing it's probably like a Bakugan. I see this brightly colored button. Can I resist pressing the brightly colored button? No, I can't. Oh, that was pretty cool. All right, so if I remember correctly, oh, you fold that up. That goes, then these go. All right, let's try this again. Yeah! I don't know if you heard that, but it's got like a little hiss to it. There's like a wind-up feature, and as it unwinds, it pops down. Okay, so we take our Battle Beasts, and we can stick them in here is what it showed. And it looks like his feet are just the tiniest bit too big. These are kind of rubbery, so they have a little bit of give. So I don't know if you're just supposed to push until it gets stuck in there, and then you just assume, hey, now it works. Okay, but these claw things here, oh, they open up. Okay, so they open and you can catch a guy in there, clamp down on him, and we've got some sort of little clamp thing here on the inside that comes down. So overall, yeah, that's pretty cool. It turns into a little vehicle, and now, I mean, this looks pretty nice. I mean, as far as having like a little vehicle for you to play with your little guys. Again, I'm not sure how well the oranges and the yellows and the reds are showing up on this camera, but that's a neat looking little toy. Now, having it kind of motorized like that is a neat effect, although they're married together, so you can't move them individually. And I mean, let's be honest, when you put it back into the cube mode. I mean, you got a cube. That's something, right? Wally's third cousin, maybe something. But, I mean, okay, look. Hey, look, Ma, I got a cube. I mean, I guess it's not as bad as, like, rock lords that look like rocks. You know, that type of stuff, the meteorbs. You know, Joe Amato, Joe, what are you thinking with the meteorbs? But you can see that even in the, I just knocked over everything. That was cool. Even in this molded plastic that's just part of the forgettable outer shell, you can see that the tank treads actually continue on to the front here. So even though the tank treads are part of this, they're actually molded on the front. And then it looks like there are some lights. So maybe this is supposed to be some sort of, like, battle cube that comes in that can withstand a lot of fire, and then it gets close enough and it pops out to attack. So I guess I'm just giving it story since I don't know Japanese, but yeah, you can see that looks like a big heavy piece of machinery. So there you go on that guy. That was something. Let's move on to this one. Now this is some sort of airplane thing. We can see by the photo in the back, and we'll once again slide my fingernails through here, even though I don't have great fingernails. Oh, of course, I can do one side, but I can't get the other. Ay, ay, ay. We'll pop him out. I don't think we need to get the little Japanese paper out because we know what's inside there. But here we have our cube and our guys. And this time we have some sort of little, oh, it's a cow and a giraffe and is that a bunny? I guess maybe a little bunny. Bunny, giraffe, and a cow. That's a fighting force you can't handle. All right. So looking at the cube here, mostly all white, little accents of gray. We've got something here that we can see kind of moves a little bit. And I'm guessing, of course, this is going to be our button. Let's set it down. Oh, that was pretty nifty. Okay. All right. I'm down with that. That's cool. We got some guns here to shoot, and we've got some sort of jail here in the back. So capture your enemies, and you toss them back there. And then you grab a gunner here. There's a spot where he sticks in there. That's not bad. And then you've got your little pilot spot here in the front. So, yeah. Yeah, overall, that's not a bad-looking little device, though. I gotta say, I want to watch that transformation again. I want to see that one more time. Everybody ready? You ready for this? Oh, well, that was great. All right, let's try again. Yeah, buddy. That is something. All right, so this thing is cool. Now, I mean, sure. Hey, look. I get to dig a hole in my bulldozer thing. Oh, really? I get to fly. I get to be awesome. I get to look like I'm part bird and hover. Look, it looks like there's a bird face on it. That's cool. Look at you. You look like you're Mr. Manual Labor. Yeah, you're a lot of fun at parties, I'm sure. But this guy's awesome. I like this one a lot. I could definitely see, I mean, if you're a kid, and you're going to get this thing to play with. I mean, not only do you have this awesome transformation that you get to deal with, but it just looks cool in this form. I mean, you could definitely see how it's a hovering, flying platform, almost like one of those Terminator ships because it's got the turbines on the sides there. That is neat. That is neat. I got to give him credit. I hope some of the others are as cool as this one. But this one's definitely a lot better than the other one. This is my new favorite one there. All right. Now, from the other two that we have here. Again, these are the light ones. Lighter background with the yellow and red. And with the white across the bottom instead of the black. So, obviously part of a different release line. Do we start with the vehicle or the headquarters thing? Let's start with this vehicle over here. Let's save that headquarters thing for last, because this is going to be more similar to the other ones that we have on there. We're going to pop this one. This one's starting to come apart a little bit already, so that's nice. Nice and easy. Pull him out. Whoop. And we lost our beasts. What kind of beasts we got on this one? We got a... I don't know what the heck this thing is. It's like a warthog, maybe? With a horn? I mean, it's not a rhino. Sure. Warthog, why not? We've got a... Looks like a bear on that one. And ooh, some sort of antelope or deer on that one. Not bad. All right, so once again, nice little sculpted figures. But our moneymaker up here... A little cube, and a lot of purple, very Decepticon looking, purple and blue, no idea, I don't see any wheels or anything, there's nothing that really screams out one thing or another, but I'm guessing, of course, that's the button, so this is going to be the top, so, oh, and I should have done it this way, let's pretend that didn't happen, let's try it again, somehow, maybe? We can bring it in. There we go. All right. Grand opening. All right. We're going to press the button. And, of course, that time. Okay. Excuse me. So, all right. So this also is a little headquarters thing now that I take a look at it. Although it does have a vehicle here in the front. How do you let go? Let go of my vehicle. I see. It's got a tension release. Woo! Look at it fly. All right. That's not bad. Cool. All right. And we've got this blue thing back here, which you would think would do something. Oh, I guess it's supposed to be like a little another gunner target thing. All right. We've got another little jail here, it looks like, with a little jail box. Although, I don't know, you know, hey, don't climb out this big hole in the side. You stay in that jail. And then over here, it looks like we've got a like a table. Dinner time, folks. Let's come over here and eat. That's not quite as exciting, I don't think. Although, but this thing is, though. I mean, you put your antelope in your go-kart, and then you just watch them, woo, stunt driving. All right, so that's not bad. I like the little car. I mean, the little car, it rolls well enough. That's neat looking. So it's okay. I still think I like that flying one better overall, but I mean, this is cool. And this as being like a little mobile command headquarters thing, you know, I mean, the table is not the most exciting thing in the world, but I mean, they got to have a strategy meeting somewhere, right? And this almost looks like a Masters of the Universe toy, doesn't it? It looks like the little, the green, yeah, so, exactly, one of those. So, you know, overall, pretty cool. Having that little guy on there is definitely unexpected to have a little car that's going to pop out, but that is cool. That is a neat thing on there. Okay, so, we've got one left here. This is the one that actually looked like a headquarters on the artwork here, so let's... Choo. Slice that right open. Those are open. Can we get this side as easy as we got the other side? Come on. There we go. All right. Oh, we're stuck at the bottom. There's a little piece. All right. Got it. And we've got more little dudes. And we can see, I can see an ape. We got an ape right here. Big gorilla. Not an Optimus Primal. I mean, these are battle beasts. These are a little different. So there's that dude. And then we've got some sort of... I don't know what this is. A wolf, maybe? That is... Man. Okay. And then we've got... Oh, this is a rhinoceros. Yeah, that's definitely a rhino. That is clear rhino right there. So... All right. So there's those guys. And then we'll get our... thingamathing out of the hole. Thingamathing. That's a thing now, is a thingamathing. And something here, something attaches. Oh, that looks like another tension release thing like we had before. I'm guessing this is the button. So is this the top then? Is that the... Yeah, that is. That's... Okay. So here we go. Little... mobile command center. We've got some sort of platform that goes across. Okay, so it looks like a repair center would be my guess. So you've got your little car here, and it's on a tension release. Although with my giant fingers, I don't know if I can get this. There it goes. Okay. All right. So you can see there's a little rotating platform here, and it's got two little holes where it looks like the back wheels fit right in there. So you come in, you get some work done. It's got to move around. The little arms come down, do the repair stuff on it. Okay. So we got all that. And then maybe if it needs some super special work done, it hangs off this thing. Because there's a clip, just like the other clip, but I'm not sure. Or it would fit this way, maybe. You'd have an extra... Or maybe weapons from the other one. Maybe this would fit in with the that other rolling car somehow. And maybe that could go in. But that slides back and forth. Bonus. Action feature. And then we've got this, which goes up and down. Okay, so I'm guessing with the wheels, you stick the wheels in there, and then it can go up. so your little dudes can go underneath. So Mr. Rhino can get underneath and do some repair work there. Mr. Ape can sit up here in the gun turret, keep everything safe, keep everybody away while work is going on. And Mr. Jackal, whatever, he can just sit up here and chill because he's got nothing to do. He's not quite, he's not as big a part of the team. He's not as key a part of the team as the Rhino or the Ape, but he's still there. He pays his dues, so he gets to stay in the club. You know what I'm saying? So overall, this is one of those, this is similar to, if you remember when I did the review of Soundwave. Here, let me flip around real quick here. When we did the review of Soundwave several months ago, and Soundwave popped out into a little playset, this is the way I thought it should be, with a higher back front that makes the back walls, because the floor can just be whatever. And with that playset, it folded out to make like a floor, and then you just had a couple little things that popped up, and it wasn't like that. You know, it was like, whatever, not that great, but, you know, it still served its purpose. This is more of what I thought that playset actually should be. Because you can see the walls make the back. It doesn't matter what's here. I mean, there's nothing here. That's just floor. That's ground. But that's okay, because that's naturally part of the space. That's part of the playset area. So this has a good look to it. So yeah, I like the look of that one. And if it combines, like if there was some way, like, I don't know, that maybe you could match them together somehow or whatever. But still, see, this one is not quite as cool because it's just stuff on the floor. And they made one of them a table. I mean, what's exciting about the table? But you see how this is just laid out flat and just kind of like, meh. Whereas this one actually uses the space. This looks good. I like the design of this. So right now, I'm going to go with this repair center. Combined with, where's my Spinaroonie metal bird thing? Here we go. All right. So this, because it's a vehicle, I mean, that's the right look for it, especially with those being wings that fold out like that. Almost, you know, I mean, it fits the Transformer idea. That's what a lot of the stuff looks like. It's just randomly like, oh, it's laying out flat, so it's got to be a wing, and somehow your mind just goes with it and it works. This vehicle, this playset, those two are the key for me. I would say that those two are the best ones in the other group. This other playset, you know, it's not terrible, and it's nice that it has a little car to it, but it's just not great. And then this, I'm glad we did this one first, because I'd be a little less excited looking at it now after all the others. It's a big truck thing. What was that? What was that story with the steam engine that like dug the big hole, but then it got stuck in the hole, and they built the building around it, and then it became the motor that moved the elevator up and down because it was pretty much useless at that point? That's what this thing is. This is one of those where it's like, oh, you're cool, you got a purpose here for a while, and then you dug yourself right into the hole. You're useless. Unless you can adapt to new technology, we got no use for you. You're just a big square. You big square. So, cool. Now, I have no idea if Borg cubes are a big thing for the Beast Saga, Beast Wars. Like, I don't know if that's part of the stories. Like, they all travel around in big cubes. They like geometric shapes. The wolves are worthless, but the ape man can do his thing. The giraffe guy's kind of weird, but overall they're cool. I love little playsets. I used to have every single piece of the Mighty Max toy line. Then, of course, I had to sell it several years back, and now I'm very sad. So, hey, if you got some Mighty Max toys laying around, you're not using them, it's Christmas time, just send it to dirt@popculturenetwork.com. I'll be more than happy to take those off your hand. But anyway, now I know some of you, though, were at the end of Formers Friday, and you're like, dude, Battle Beasts, fine, whatever, but those aren't Transformers. We've gone through this entire thing, and we haven't seen one single Transformer, dude. And I'll say, okay, there you go. It's an Optimus Prime from Fisher-Price. Congratulations. Have a nice day.